The Ministry of Industry and Commerce has held a stakeholders meeting to deliberate on the Economic Empowerment Bill at a local hotel in Bulawayo. The exercise brought together captains of industry, non-governmental organizations, development organizations, owners of businesses, and investors. The engagement sought to deliberate on the ways to repeal the current Indigenization and Economic Empowerment Act, which is the root cause of investor flight from Zimbabwe. This view was supported by the Western Region of the Zimbabwe Congress of Trade Unions Chairperson, Mr. Ambrose Sibendi.
As the labor organization have always been against this issue of saying 51.9%, the meaning says that the local person must always have a share of 51% and the investor 49%. We have been arguing that that alone was not investor friendly, that policy. It was throwing away the investors. And now we are happy that this bill, if it goes through, the act will be clear that that thing has been abolished, which I think is a plus to the country, because it will attract investors, knowing that when they come here with their monies, they will really use them to the fullest. And again, there are issues to do with that we need to discuss about this bill. Issues to do with the employment of the local people. I think we are aware that there is a clause that says they must plow back to the locals when investors come here, which I think is a good thing. Plowing back how? In terms of employment, even in terms of putting some money to develop the local area, which I think is a good thing as well. So these are the things that I say that they are very positive. And again, the issue of employment, share ownership, trust. We all know that in the previous act, the challenge there was that there were two schemes. There was a scheme for the lower people, for the general workforce, and then the management. We thought that one was highly discriminatory, but we are pushing for one scheme that managers and any general worker must be part of that trust without discriminating, say that one is for elite and this one is for the poor. I think that's the right approach, because in the scientific world that we are living in, we have gone past that stage. So in short, that's what I can say about this year.
Dr. Saruzai Simango from the Department of Accounting and Finance from Lupane State University concurred that the Indigenization Act should be repealed.
I think the Economic Empowerment Act is going to bring us an improvement in the levels of investments compared to the Indigenization and Empowerment Act that we had before. Because it has dealt with some of the sticking points that we had in the initial act, for example, the 51.49% share ownership and also other issues that had challenges with international investors before.
The acting director in the Ministry of Industry and Commerce, Mrs. Mary Chingonzo, had this to say.
That's been amended. It's about the issues that were in the current bill, in the current act, that the bill is trying to address, like the 51.49 for the extractive sector, which when the Second Republic came in.
The acting director in the Ministry of Industry and Commerce also had this to say.
I think within the small medium enterprise sector, what we're looking at the impact of the bill is it will actually encourage the build-up of micro small medium enterprises, not necessarily within the FN setup, but we're also looking at within the rural setup. I think we're also aware that local authorities, both FN and rural, are encouraged actually to put industrial space for micro small medium enterprises. So I'm seeing this bill as a facilitator to actually put that scheme. So that then people start with the company. One feature which is there is there's going to be a fund, which fund is going to be used to also partial capitalization of micro small medium enterprises, and also encouraging startups. So I think this is one thing which has been lacking insofar as the micro small medium enterprise sector was concerned, where people were now scrambling for where do we get capital to actually start up our businesses. Yes, there are business ideas which are there, but we need to fund them. So I think this bill, the minute it comes as an act, should be a positive statement. And also you realize it's actually looking at the environment.
Reporting for ZMGPC News, Brunette Chuma.